Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can create custom report types in Salesforce so that you can use that custom report type while creating reports. So before starting, if you go to description of this video, you will find various links related to our Salesforce playlist. So you can follow them if you want to learn more Salesforce. So first of all, let me tell you how we can search report type in the setup. So you can type report type. So this link will be available. If you click on this, so here you can see custom report types option is available. And if you go to reports tab and click on new reports, so here you can see all available standard as well as custom report types. So many of them are standard, but if you create any custom report type, so that will be available in these categories. So you can click on particular category and the related report types will be displayed here so that you can create reports. So now I'm going to explain this first. So here you can see the explanation of custom report type is available. So custom report types allows you to build a framework in the report wizard from which users can create and customize reports. You build custom report types of the relationships. So you can choose master detail and lookup as well. So between objects so that you can choose which objects to display to users creating and customizing reports. So first important thing is objects. So that we need to choose. Second is define the relationship between objects displayed to users creating and customizing reports. So second important thing is relationship between objects. And third is select which objects fields can be used as columns in reports. So third, we need to choose the fields that will be available while creating the reports. So after this, I'm going to click on continue so that we can create custom report types. So click on new custom report type. So here you can create custom report types for both standard as well as custom objects. So here you need to put or you need to select the primary object. So let's say I'm selecting accounts as primary object, then label account with opportunities. So I'm going to create this report type and description is same, account with opportunities. Now here I need to select the categories. So if we click on new report, so in this pop-up, the left-hand side, whatever you are seeing is the category. So I'm going to choose other reports. So right now in other reports, you can see accounts with opportunity report type is not available. So I'm going to choose other reports. So this report type will be available there. I'm clicking on next. So here primary object is account. Then I'm going to choose a secondary object that is opportunity. So if I click on this drop down, so here opportunities is available. So I'm choosing that. So it is giving two options, A to B relationship. So each A record must have at least one related B record. And second option is A records may or may not have related B record. So if you choose first option, then account should be related to any opportunity, then those record will be available. And if you choose second option, then account may or may not have related B like opportunity. So let's say I'm choosing second. So all accounts will be, account record will be displayed whether they have related opportunities or not. So here you can see the colors are changed. If I choose first option, so it is highlighting this one only. So first option will show those records, those account record which have related opportunities. But if I choose second option, so here you can see those accounts, those account records, they don't have any opportunity will be available. And the account records which will be having opportunities associated will be. So both type of records will be there. So I'm choosing second option. If you want one more level, so you can choose one more object for B2C relationship. So these are related to opportunities. So you can choose anyone from here. So I am not choosing this one right now and clicking on save. So this way we choose primary and the related objects so that our custom report type will be created. So this is the relationship that we are using. So accounts with or without related records from opportunities will be available for reports. And here you can see these are the fields that will be available for the report. If you click on edit layout, so from here you can add or remove the fields that you want to use while creating reports. So first accounts fields are displayed and then opportunities record fields are displayed. And these will be available while creating report. If you want to remove anyone, let's say you want to remove employees. So select this. So here colors are available. Whatever you do, you can relate with this color. So this is for selected. So this is right now selected. And if I click drag and drop it here. So here you can see employee is removed from here and it is available here and it is highlighted as this. So not in page layout. So this will not be available. Right. And if you want to use it, so you can drag and drop simply so that it will be available. And if you want to see opportunities fields, so you can click on that. And this way you can add and remove opportunity fields as well. And if you want to change the properties, so you can click on a particular field, click on this added opportunities. If you want to preview the layout, you can click on this. So this way you can customize this report type so that the required or desired fields will be available while creating the reports. Now I'm clicking on save so that this report type will be available to create reports. So now if I go here and do a refresh, and if I choose new report, so you will see in other reports category that report type will be available. So from here, I'm going to click on other reports. So here, right now it is not available. So again, I'm doing a refresh. Clicking on new reports. Yeah, here you can see accounts with opportunities, report type is available. So choose this, click on continue. And now your report builder is opened. And if you click here, so all the fields related to account and then related to opportunities are available. And with the help of this columns, you can choose those fields that you want to add here. So this is all about how we can use standard as well as custom report types. So standards are standards can be used directly by clicking on new report. And for custom, you need to apply the whole process that I demonstrated in this video. And now next question is how to create different types of reports. So for that, you need to follow the playlist that is reports and dashboards in Salesforce. So if you watch my another video that is related to various types of report, how we can create them, so then you will be understanding like how we can create different type of reports. So I hope in this video you understood how we can create report types, that to custom report types related to standard as well as custom objects, and how we can use that report type to create reports. So this is all about this video. And if you go to description of this video, then you will find the playlist link related to reports and dashboards. So open that and you can view all reports and dashboard related videos. Thank you for watching this video.